The golden glove for most clean sheets, most errors that lead to goals conceded, missing passes and not sweeping. There are a lot of pros and cons about David De Gea, but there's a feeling among the United dressing room that he needs to leave, already this summer. And maybe he even has to leave for his own sake. Let's find out. Despite the fact that David De Gea has been one of Manchester United's best players since joining in 2011, doubts have emerged regarding his suitability for the team's future under Erik Ten Hag. Although his 17 clean sheets in 38 league games were enough to win him the Premier League Golden Glove Award this season, his inconsistent form throughout the season and unconvincing distribution have highlighted the need for a change. This video will explore the reasons why it's crucial for the 32-year-old Spaniard to depart from the club this summer. Erik Ten Hag's first season as Manchester United's manager has generally been a success. The team has secured the League Cup and achieved a commendable third-place finish in the Premier League, surpassing the expectations of many fans. The arrival of new players such as Casemiro, Christian Eriksen, and Lisandro Martinez has injected a sense of optimism at Old Trafford. Additionally, there is anticipation regarding the potential contributions of Tyrell Malacia and Antony in the upcoming seasons. However, one position that remained unchanged in the 2022-23 season was the goalkeeper, with David De Gea retaining his place as the team's trusted guardian since the 2011-12 season. Upon joining United last summer, Ten Hag clearly expressed his desire to implement a more progressive and proactive style of play at the club. A crucial aspect of Ten Hag's system is the goalkeeper's ability to excel with the ball at their feet. Unfortunately, on numerous occasions this season, United experienced instances of losing possession when De Gea was in possession of the ball. While the consequences were not always significant, they did impede the team from reaching its full potential. Despite some of De Gea's good performances throughout the season, where he made important saves and climbed the ranks of all-time Premier League clean sheets, doubts have arisen regarding his suitability as the team's starting goalkeeper. These doubts primarily stem from concerns about his distribution and reluctance to sweep behind the defense. One notable critic of De Gea is Roy Keane, who, despite witnessing the goalkeeper receive the Premier League Golden Glove Award, expressed his blunt opinion, stating, "I would quickly move him on. De Gea, he's not for me. He won't bring Manchester United back to winning trophies. Absolutely not." While Erik Ten Hag, on the other hand, has consistently defended De Gea against handling errors and kicking issues, his recent comments after the FA Cup final suggest a preference for a goalkeeper who is more naturally adept at playing out from the back. When asked about De Gea's ball-playing abilities, Ten Hag stated, "We're heading in the right direction, but there are occasions and issues in the game that we need to improve if we want to take the next step and win trophies." In light of these circumstances, Manchester United continues to monitor the goalkeeper market. Several names have been linked with a potential move to the club this summer, including Diogo Costa from FC Porto, David Raya from Brentford, Jordan Pickford from Everton, and Andre Onana from Inter. The impact of Ten Hag's changes at Manchester United can already be observed. Among Europe's top five leagues this season, only Paris Saint-Germain with 10 goals have registered more fast-break goals than United's 9. In the Premier League, United leads in direct attacks with 102 and goals resulting from such situations with 9. As Ten Hag's tenure at Old Trafford progresses, one aspect likely to develop is United's positioning on the pitch, particularly in terms of their high line. At Ajax, Ten Hag's side would often start their open play passing sequences higher up the pitch than most sides. This approach had multiple advantages. It limited the distance to the opponent's goal, kept teammates in closer proximity, and facilitated the recovery of possession if it was lost. Overall, since Ten Hag's first full season in charge of Ajax, his team has consistently ranked first in the Eredivisie for average start distance and high turnovers. While there's still work to be done in his current project at United, these statistics are expected to continue heading in a positive direction. Having a goalkeeper of Andre Onana's caliber, who has also been linked with a potential switch, even though with less intensity, allows teams to play with a higher defensive line. This is an attribute that De Gea doesn't quite possess in comparison to Costa and Raya. Since the beginning of the 2021-22 season, Raya has performed 38 successful sweeper actions in the Premier League, ranking 6th among goalkeepers and only being surpassed by 5 others during that period. His ability to anticipate danger and confidently intercept passes or pressure opponents give the defenders ahead of him the confidence to push higher up the pitch. In contrast, De Gea's recorded only 19 successful sweeper actions in the same time frame, placing him 16th among Premier League goalkeepers. These deficiencies make it challenging for United to defend with confidence and sustain effective attacks. Furthermore, De Gea has frequently displayed signs of nervousness when attempting higher-risk passes from his own box during open play. Consequently, it is unsurprising that his goal kicks in the Premier League this season have often consisted of safer options, either short passes to a defender inside the box or long balls to a teammate in the opposition's half. Considering Ten Hag's emphasis on having a proactive goalkeeper who actively contributes to the team's build-up play, it becomes evident that De Gea's reactive style is ill-suited for the team's future. Despite his popularity among the players in the dressing room, the club must prioritize constructing a squad capable of executing the manager's vision. This may entail making difficult decisions regarding personnel. However, amidst all of the discussions, it's important not to overlook the primary duty of a goalkeeper, which is to prevent the ball from entering the net. While the role of a goalkeeper has undoubtedly evolved, shot-stopping remains a fundamental aspect. De Gea has received praise for his shot-stopping abilities in the past, but this season his performance in this regard has been less than exceptional, and he has committed costly errors in several matches, with a negative 0-5 goals prevented. It's worth noting that De Gea has conceded slightly more goals than what would be expected from an average goalkeeper, considering the quality of shots he has faced. While this doesn't necessarily condemn the Spaniard, it does raise doubts about whether he is currently at the peak of his shot-stopping prowess, and for some, that's his only redeeming quality. Even in terms of more proactive aspects, such as catching high balls into the box and confidently coming off his line, De Gea lags behind. Although this has never been his greatest strength, as he has relied more on reflexes and reactionary saves, it appears that the club and the player have potentially reached an impasse. Currently, De Gea has not signed a new contract, and there are reports suggesting that club officials are hesitant to approve one. The club recently confirmed that ongoing discussions regarding a potential new contract with De Gea are taking place, but they are aiming to reduce his weekly wages significantly from £375,000 to only £200,000. Notably, De Gea was not included in the club's list of retained players for the upcoming season, as announced last week. So, who would be a suitable successor to David De Gea? If Manchester United and Ten Hag decide to replace De Gea this summer, Raya or Costa would be ideal candidates. The Red Devils might even consider negotiating the £40 million asking price with Brentford, especially since Raya has just over a year remaining on his contract. Costa, who is Portugal's number one and 4 years younger than De Gea at 23, could be viewed as a better long-term option, although his price tag is expected to be considerably higher. Another potential replacement could be Onana. Ten Hag is familiar with Onana, as he was a regular goalkeeper at Ajax under the Dutchman's management. He possesses exceptional passing abilities, confidence with a ball at his feet, excellent command of his penalty area, and outstanding shot-stopping skills. These qualities were evident during Inter's journey into the Champions League final, where they narrowly lost 1-0 against Manchester City. Despite the defeat, the 27-year-old showcased his status as a world-class goalkeeper. He perfectly embodies the type of goalkeeper that Ten Hag desires in order to maximize the effectiveness of his system. It's not difficult to imagine Onana anchoring United's defense, orchestrating play from the back, or launching long passes to a sprinting Rashford. Throughout Ten Hag's tenure at Manchester United, the prevailing narrative has been one of progress, both in terms of defining the team's identity and seasonal objectives. To fully embrace this new era, it becomes evident that replacing their goalkeeper is one of the most logical decisions they can make. It may appear harsh to part ways with a player like De Gea, who has been a dedicated servant and has given his all to the club. However, the reality is that as long as he remains the team's goalkeeper, United must acknowledge that he significantly constrains Ten Hag's system in the long run. This is the primary and most compelling rationale behind the need for United to move forward and secure a new goalkeeper during this summer transfer window. Either way, United's future looks to be in good hands thanks to Erik Ten Hag. If you want to learn more about how he handled all the difficulties regarding the World Cup and the clash with Cristiano Ronaldo, be sure to check out this video next. We value your input and would love to hear your thoughts and opinions on our analysis. Please, feel free to share them in the comments section below. If you found this video engaging, don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay updated and ensure you don't miss out on our exciting future content. Thank you for watching.